Good morning, students. Till now, we have done all the exercises and all the concepts of our chapter 5, that is data handling. Now, after completion of this chapter, today I have planned to discuss all the questions of worksheet. Okay, worksheet and two assignments I have given you, assignment 17 and assignment 18. So, today we will discuss all its solutions. First of all, I am talking about worksheet 1. In worksheet 1, in the beginning, I have given you some important points which you have to write in your notebook. Okay? And then answer the following question. This worksheet 1 was based on the first video, very first video which we have done. And the questions are also very simple. So let's discuss its answers so that you all can check your answers that whatever you people have done is right or wrong. Okay? First question is read the following paragraph and answer the following questions. पैराग्राफ दिया हुआ है आपको यू ऑल कैन लुक एट द क्वेश्चन विच इज गिवन टू यू एंड देन वी हैव टू आंसर इट इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव टू राइट दैट व्हाट इज द इंफॉर्मेशन गिवन बाय द पैराग्राफ अगर आप पैराग्राफ को ध्यान से देखें तो आपको उस ग्राफ को देख के क्या इंफॉर्मेशन दी हुई है ऑन एक्स एक्सिस ईयर इज रिटन 2003 to 2004 then 4 to 5 ओके academic years are given and on y axis what is given number of students in class 8 okay ki class 8 mein kitne bacche hain so same we will write that the bar graph gives the information of number of students in class 8 in academic years from 2003 to 2008. Okay, only this much information is given by the graph. The second part is in which year is the increase in the number of students is maximum. For that, we have to find the difference of now in which year is the increase in the number of students is maximum. सबसे ज्यादा increase कब हुआ? ठीक है, जैसे 2003 से 2004 के बीच में 100 बच्चे हैं, ओके देन 4 टू 5 के बीच में 200, ओके सो 2004 to 2005 के जो बीच में गैप है 100 स्टूडेंट्स इंक्रीज ओके देन फ्रॉम 2005 to 2006 में अगर आप देखेंगे so in 2005 there were 200 and then 250 so 50 students increased then 2006 to 2007 how many have increased again 50 have increased and then 2007 to 2008 again 50 have increased so in which year the increase was maximum thus from 2004 to 2005 the increase was maximum okay similarly in third part they are asking that in which year is the number of students maximum then definitely in last graph is the at the highest so in 2007 and 2008 the number of students is maximum students you all have to write complete answer no one will write answer in the short form like only this you are writing as you have grown up so make a habit of writing complete answers now in fourth part is the number of students during 2005 to 2006 is twice of that of 2003 to 4. Okay. Now, what is the strength from 2003 to 2004? In that, the strength is 100. Okay. But from 2005 to 2006, the strength is 200. Okay. So, what we will say? Yes. The number of students during 2005 to 2006 is double. Like you can complete the question from the which is given in the question only 2003 to 2004. I am not writing the complete answers, but you have to write complete statements. Now moving to our next question, again let's read the following paragraph. Now the double paragraph is given to you. Now what is the information given by the double paragraph? Now instead of writing, I will discuss those answers with you, because one I have shown you how you have to do, remaining you can do it by yourself. So in the first part, what is the information? So on x-axis we can see subjects are given, and on y-axis marks obtained by a student. So what does the graph depict? The double bar graph gives the information of marks obtained by students in different subjects. That's it. Okay. That only you have to write. जो भी आप graph क्या बता रहा है, that is dependent on what is written on x-axis and what is written on y-axis. ठीक है. Then in second part, in which subject has the performance improved the most? तो आपको कंपेयर करना है, जो डबल पैराग्राफ बना है वी हैव टू कंपेयर कि किसमें परफॉर्मेंस सबसे ज्यादा बढ़ी है. सो वी ऑल कैन आइडेंटिफाई दैट इन मैथ्स द परफॉर्मेंस हैज इंक्रीज द मोस्ट. सो सेकंड पार्ट का आंसर क्या हुआ? इन मैथ्स. इन थर्ड पार्ट, इन विच सब्जेक्ट द परफॉर्मेंस हैज डिटीरिएटेड. डिटीरिएटेड मीन्स कम हो गई है, घट गई है. तो किसमें कम हो गई है? इसका ग्राफ नीचे गया है, इंग्लिश का. So in English, the performance has got deteriorated. In English. Third part ka answer kya hai? English. Fourth part, in which the subject is performance at par. Par means are at equal rate. Okay. So we can see that in Hindi, the subject performance is at par. Now in third question, a group of students was asked for their favorite subject. So favorite subject ki list di hui hai. Okay. Now, first thing you have to do, answer the following question. Which is the most liked subject and which is the least liked subject? Now, to give this answer, we have to make a frequency distribution table. Simple frequency distribution table. Okay. आप लोग कैसे table बनाएंगे? इसमें सबसे पहले लिखेंगे subject. Okay. And then, telemarks. And then frequency. Okay, these three things you will write in the table. Now supposing this, first you will write art, maths, science, English, and so on. You will write, like for art you will mark a line, for maths you will mark another line, for science then English, then again maths, then again art, English, then maths, then English, art, then science, then art, science, maths, art, English, maths, art, English, then again art, then science, then maths, then science, and then art. Okay, so this is the data given to you. Now, which is the most like? This is 7 in number, 4 in number, 7 and 4. Okay, 7 4 7 4. Now, which is the most liked subject? Art and science. Art and science are the most liked subject. And which is the least liked? Maths and English are the least liked subject. So, in this way, your worksheet 1 is completed. You all can check your answers that whatever you people have done is right or wrong. Now, I am moving to assignment 17. Okay, students, now we are going to start our next assignment, assignment 17. Let's discuss his answer. Question 1 is, write down in the class interval 5 to 10. Okay, 5 to 10 class interval is given to us. Now, the first part is, what is its lower limits? Very easy, 5. What its upper limit? It's 10. And what is its class mark? Now, class mark you people have not studied. Let me tell you its formula. For class mark, what we do? Class mark is equal to lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Means 5 plus 10 upon 2, that is 7.5. This will be the class mark. And class mark you will use when you will come in class 9th. You will draw frequency polygon. On the basis of histogram, we can draw frequency polygon. So when you will learn that, then you will understand the importance of class marks. And then in the fourth part, what is the class size? Class size we can find out by the formula that upper limit minus lower limit. That is 10 minus 5, which is equal to 5. So in this way, first question is done. Now coming to your question number 2. A group of 10-20 students recorded their heights. The data received were as given below. Now what is the range? For finding the range, we have the formula. In class 7th, you must have studied this. Highest value minus lowest value. This is the formula for range. Now how we can find out the range? Now when you will look at the data carefully, what is the highest value? I think 160 is the highest value. And what is the lowest value? Lowest value is 120. I can't find any, 112. Yes, 112 is the lowest value. And there is no other value less than 112. And there is 161, 165. Okay, so the highest value is not 160, that is 165. Okay, so 165 and the lowest is 112. So when you will subtract it, it will come 53. So the range of the data is 53. Range means that from what minimum to what maximum your data varies. Okay, kahan se kahan tak aapka data vary karta hai, that is range. So our data varies from 112, sabse kam ye hai aur sabse zyada ye hai, yahan tak vary karta hai. So 53 is the range of the data. Now coming to next question, that is question number 3. Construct the frequency table for the following marks obtained by 50 students by taking equal intervals from 16 to 24 as one of the class interval. Okay, so means we have to take a gap of 8, 8. So we will draw the frequency, a group frequency distribution table. For question number 3, it will not be a simple frequency distribution table, it will be a group frequency table. First one will be class interval. In the first it will be class interval, and then telemarks, and then frequency. As I have told you, if supposedly 16 to 24 is the class interval, and next will be 24 to 30, then, it should be 32, then 32 se lekar 40 tak. In this way, then 40 to 48. As there is a gap of 8. Now when we will draw the telemarks, if 24 is there, then 24 we will not count in the first class interval. We will count it in the second class interval. So now you all can count and I will draw it here. Okay students, so I have made the complete frequency distribution table and this is the grouped frequency distribution table. So you all can check your answer that whatever you people have done is right or wrong. Now coming to your question number 4, the double bar graph. Downside you can see the double bar graph which shows the average monthly temperature of two cities over 4 months period. ठीक है, 4 महीने में देहरादून और दिल्ली के बीच में जो भी temperature changes हैं that has been plotted in the double bar graph. Now you have to answer the question. What does each 1 centimeter block on vertical axis represent? So y axis पे जो 1 unit है that is equal to 10 degree Celsius. Means in short they want to know the scale of the graph. Okay? So fourth question का first part होगा 1 centimeter is equal to 10 degree Celsius. Similarly, second part, what does the average monthly temperature in Dehradun in March, April, May, June? आपको 4 महीने में पूछा है. March में क्या temperature है? 30 degree Celsius. अच्छा, average पूछा है. Okay. Now, the horizontal line is for Dehradun and vertical line is for जो graph में जो shading हो रखी है. जो horizontal line है ऐसे ऐसे. That is for Dehradun. And this line is for Delhi. तो आपको पूछा what was the average monthly temperature of in Dehradun in March. So in March it is 25 degree Celsius. Okay. March में कितनी है? 25 degree Celsius. Then April में, in April it is 35 degree Celsius approximately, I am writing. Okay. And then in May it's 40 degree Celsius and in June it's 35 degree Celsius. Okay, so in this way you can do second question, all the D, A, B, C, D, A, B, C and D parts. And in third part, what was the every monthly temperature in Delhi for the whole 4 months? Ab similarly aapko Delhi ka batana hai, March mein kitna hai, अप्रैल में कितना है, मई में कितना है एंड देन व्हाट इज द टेम्परेचर इन जून. सो इन मार्च द टेम्परेचर ऑफ दिल्ली इज 30, इन अप्रैल द टेम्परेचर इज 40, इन मई द टेम्परेचर इज, यस इन मई द टेम्परेचर इज 45 एंड इन जून द टेम्परेचर इज 50 degree Celsius. Okay, approximate. You can place a scale to measure the temperature. Now, in which months was the difference between the temperature of Delhi and Dehradun was maximum and by how much? Now, kis mein sabse zyada? This is of Dehradun and this is of Delhi. Okay, so here the difference is of 5. Here the difference is of 5. Here also 5. But here the difference in the temperature is of 15 degree Celsius. So what is the answer? In June, the difference is maximum. The difference is maximum by 15 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is all about your question number 4. And in question number 5, the table is given to you. And what you have to prepare the following data represent the number of students in a school playing in 6 different states. Now you have to draw bar graph for this. Question number 5 में हमें क्या बनाना है? Bar graph. Nothing else we have to draw. And in question number 6, histogram is given to you. On the basis of histogram, you have to make this grouped frequency distribution table. So table will be like this. First will be of class interval. Second group will be of telemarks. And third group will be of frequency. So in the first group, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30 like this. And telemarks no need to make. Directly you can write frequency. 35, 30, 45, 40, 10, 15 like this. This column you will remove. Only class interval and frequency you have to make. Like opposite, from this table we can make histogram. And from histogram we can make this table. So you have to make this table for the given histogram. Telemarks also you can show. So this is all about your assignment 17. Your next assignment we will discuss in our
next class.
Thank you, students. The next assignment, that is assignment 18, is all about from your trainees that we can discuss in our online class also. So now you will complete all the assignments and worksheet on today's date. And today I have shown you the answers also. So you all can do the cross checking. So thank you, students. Now the next topic we will start in our next class.